You're a podcaster who's interested in growing your audience. You're here at Podfest Masterclass. You want more attention. You want more listeners, more sponsors, more, more, more. But how do you do it? Well, stick with me because I'm going to tell you how you can power up your podcast marketing with wired PR energy. You ready? Let's go. So what we're going to cover today in 5 minutes is wired PR, not just one, but two case studies. And we also have a special offer. Just a side note on case studies. I like the CPR method, which is challenge. So what's the challenge? And for me, the challenge was to get attention, not just for myself, but for the event and also my topic. The next thing was the process, which is the public relations process. And then the result. Stick with us. We're going to show you that. So here we go. So what in the world is wired PR? It's the name of my blog, which I started in 2016, 15 years ago. So WIRED stands for words, intentions, routes, experiences, and design in 4D, digital, direct, dynamic, and data. And it's all wrapped around personality and reputation. So that your personality, your listener's personality, and your reputation as the number one podcaster in your genre. So let's dive into case study number one. And when I presented at Podfest Global, I had no idea I'd be doing this PR masterclass case study. And so here we go. This is the release is all done. So we're distributing it. Page one of the distribution, it's sent out to a lot of different destinations. And then let's look at the Google results. So here we are. If you're searching for Podfest Global, automatically we're getting more attention for the event. You can see that on page one, I'm a top story. And also I was, the release was mentioned there as well. Now with podcast marketing, that was a search term I dialed into the release, and we can see that it is on news, it's number one out of over 119 million results. I didn't take a lot of screenshots. I did summarize the Google results, and you can see what they are for the search terms here. Now then, does this keep growing? Yeah, it's just mushroom. So you can see two sets of results. And the ones you're going to see in color are the ones I took just this week. You can see that there's still headline impressions growing and people are sending it by email. So that's still doing its job. Now, case study number two is what I did. I sent this out 2 days before I recorded this video because I thought, oh, I need more numbers. So anyway, page one, page one, page one, page one. And then let's look at Google. So we're going to zip through this Podfest Masterclass. Here I am, the top of 37,000 results, podcast marketing PR case study. This is what really blew me away. This is of all of Google, not just news, all of Google, number three. So it's really hard to get that kind of Google juice. Don't you love Google juice? I know I do. So anyway, here I am all the way, almost to the very top. Well, first page, which is very, very good. And just a little bit of a note here, Google and Google News are different. Both of them will change every day. So what you see now or on this show, you're not going to see when you go to Google today, or you might. It could last a few weeks. It could last years. Who knows? Anyway, more search terms, PR Masterclass. Then we've got, this is PR Masterclass. Then we've got Podcast Masterclass. So you can see there we are number one, podcast marketing case study, number one, podcast marketing. And then how do you figure out what happens with this? Google will notify you when it indexes your PR if you have a Google alert. So set up a Google alert. And if you want something even better, do TalkWalker, because TalkWalker will sweep the entire web and bring back the results for you. Now, the distribution system I use also includes local. And when I was in Chicago, I had to work to get into the Daily Herald. Now, all I have to do is submit, and there I am. Now, just a note about how your podcast can bring you PR without you even doing a press release. This is an interview I did for Influence Pros. I also put it on my blog post. And then that was in 2017. This month, I was featured in the Upstate Business Journal as a podcaster who runs Convince and Converts Influence Pros. I do not. So I went on their Facebook page and I said, thank you, but that wasn't me. So anyway, it was just really wonderful to get this kind of attention 4 years later. So let's rewind real quick. What are you going to need to do? You're going to have an event or an episode, a story, a press release, weave in your SEO, distribute it, pop to the top, and then show off and show everyone how great your Google results are. How can you do that? With the Wired PR Primer. So you can get an attention attractor, you can build your influence, you can make news, not noise. And here's where you go to get it. You go to wiredprprimer.com. That's wiredprprimer.com. Use code PODFEST2021. That will take your course registration fee from $97 down to zero. So I'd love to give you this as my gift because I'd love to see you in the news. I'd love to listen to your show because you do deserve more attention, more listeners, and better sponsors. And most of all, I want you to say,
that was easy.
Right. Okay. Thanks so much. I'm Barbara Rozgonyi, and I look forward to seeing you online and listening to you on your podcast. Take care. Bye.